salutation to His Holiness today. Respected Samaniji, brothers and sisters. Today, first of all, I would like to share a story with all of you. This story is from our ancient literature. Bhagwan Rishabhdev, when he was a worldly person, lay person, he had two wives, Sumangala and Sunanda. By Sumangala, he had 99 sons, of whom Bharat was the eldest one and well known, and one daughter named Brahmi. From Sunanda, he had one son named Bahubali and one daughter named Sundari. They all were given very proper training in art and craft. Later on, Bharat turned out to be a great warrior and politician. Bahubali was known for his mighty arms. Sanskrit means Bahubali ka arth kya? Bahu atle arm and Bali atle strong. So Bahubali was tall, strong, and he had very strong arms. So that's why he was known Bahubali. Jiski bhujai bahut shaktishali. He was very strong, very powerful. Being a king, Bhagwan Rishabhdev had very big kingdom. So at the time of his renouncement, he handed over the one area, it is called Vanita or Vinita. Nowadays we call it Ayodhya, that is in UP, to Bharat. Takshila, at present it is in Bihar, to Bahubali. To remaining 98 sons, he gave different parts of his kingdom and then he became a monk. Now, Bharat was very ambitious and wanted to expand his kingdom and wanted to become an emperor of whole India. So he paid his attention towards his brothers and asked them to accept his superiority or to fight. His 98 brothers, they saw futility in fighting with their elder brother, so they surrendered their area, their countries to their brother. And they became monk, disciple of Bhagwan Rishabhdev. Now, Bahubali was of different thought. He was too proud to surrender. He was very mighty, brave, and he had capacity to fight. So, when he got request from Bharat, he rejected it and became ready to fight. Now, both brothers were very strong, very brave, courageous, and it was sure that if war will take place, it will result in large-scale bloodshed. So the counselors on both sides, they tried to advise their masters not to go ahead with war, but none of them was safe. They didn't accept it. So then, counselors decided to have a duel instead of having a war, so that can prevent large-scale bloodshed. Both brothers agreed. Duel took place Bharat tried to beat his brother, just using so many equipment that was in his command, but he couldn't get success. Now Bharat became very anxious. He was worried. How could he accept defeat from his younger brother? So, just to kill Bahubali, Bharat broke all the rules of the duel and he threw the magic wheel, chakra. जब चक्रवर्ती राजा का चक्र होता है, Bahubali को मारने के लिए उन्होंने चक्र छोड़ दिया. But चक्र कुंड किल Bahubali, because जो चक्र होता है, it was not meant to kill the person who is from the same blood. जिसका ब्लड सेम है, उसको चक्र मार नहीं सकता है. So the चक्र came again, it returned without killing Bahubali. Now Bahubali became so furious, so angry, became mad on Bharat, and he thought, my elder brother, and if he didn't have any kind of love towards me, and the main thing is that he has broken the rules of duel, now I will not live. And he thought to kill Bharat with his mighty fist. So just as he raised his hand to kill Bharat, the whole public, audience, onlookers, they trembled, because they saw the forthcoming death of Bharat. Suddenly, Bahubali got a thought, and he thought, I am going to kill my brother, elder brother, only for the sake of this material position. And that position has been given up by my father, by my other brothers. And then he thought, it's not good to kill my elder brother. Always I respected him. How can I kill him? It's not good. He saw evil in killing, but at the same place, he was so proud, he has so much pride, egoistic. So he thought, how can my hand can be returned empty? Agar maine haath utha diya hai, to khali haath nahi ja sakta. And then, his raised hand, he brought towards his head and started to pull out all the hairs. Became ready to become a monk. Loj kar diya and decided to renounce everything to become a monk. Okay? Decided. But again, the ego was playing its role. And he thought, I'm going to become a monk, and that's why I will have to go to Bhagwan Rishabdev's assembly. How can I go? Why? Because my 98 younger brothers, those already have become monks, and now they have become senior than me. If I go there, I will have to salute them. I will have to bow down to them. I can't do that. I am elder. How can I bow down to my younger brother? Although in a way they were senior, but his ego was saying, I can't salute them. And that's why, on the very spot, he stood in meditation. And he said, okay, I will get enlightenment my own and own. I will not go anywhere. Stood there in meditation, in total relaxation, total kayotsa. And you all know how long he stood? 1 year. He stood in the same position without any single movement. Itna stable ki bell, creeper hoti hai. Creepers grew on his body, taking support of his legs and body. Birds made their nests on his body. But he didn't move. He was so adamant, he was so particular, so confident, I will get enlightenment on my own. आप देखिए कितनी हार्ड प्रैक्टिस, एक साथ न खाया न पिया न चले न बोले, वेरी स्टेबल. वी डू प्रेक्षा मेडिटेशन, अभी समी जी ने कराया. वी डू कायोसर, हाउ लॉन्ग? ओनली 5 मिनट. वी डू कायोसर ओनली 5 मिनट. But in that 5 minutes, how many people are stable, totally movementless? If you want to go in deep meditation, the first condition is sharir ki sthirta, stability of your body, stillness of your body. Aap atma ko pana chahte, you need to first stable your body. Kaise? Let me give an example. घड़ा है, पिक्चर. पिक्चर में पानी है, वॉटर है. पानी हिल रहा है. क्यों हिल रहा है? Why it is moving? Because घड़ा हिल रहा है. If you want to make stable the water, first thing you have to stable the पिक्चर, घड़ा. अगर आपको पानी को स्थिर करना है तो you need to stable the घड़ा. फर्स्ट यू नीड टू मेक स्थिर घड़ा. जब तक घड़ा स्थिर नहीं होगा, पानी स्थिर नहीं होगा. इन द सेम वे, जब तक बॉडी स्थिर नहीं होगी, यू कांट स्टेबल योर माइंड एंड यू कांट रीच टू योर सोल. सो बाहुबली स्टूड 1 ईयर कॉन्स्टेंटली कंटिन्यूअसली इन स्टिलनेस meditation, but he didn't get enlightenment. बहुत सारे कर्म झड़ गए, all other karmas were shed, but he couldn't get enlightenment, he couldn't get success. One day, as I said earlier, Bhagwan Rishabhdev has 2 daughters. What was the name? Brahmi and Sundari. They already they had become nuns. So one day they asked their father, Bhagwan Rishabhdev, Tirthankar Rishabhdev, Prabhu, where is our brother Bahubali? What is he doing? Has he achieved enlightenment? Kya unko keval gyan ho gaya hai? Kya wo sadhana kar rahe hai? Where is he? And that time Bhagwan Rishabhdev said, no, he is still meditating, he hasn't got enlightenment yet. Brahmi and Sundari, they asked, why? If he is still meditating, constantly 1 year he is meditating, why did he not get enlightenment? And Bhagwan Rishabhdev said, very shallow pride prevents him to achieve enlightenment. एक छोटा सा अहम उसके भीतर है और वो अहम उसको रोक रखा है केवल ज्ञान पाने का. ब्राह्मी एंड सुंदरी विद देयर अफेक्शन दे केम टू द प्लेस वेयर बाहुबली वॉज स्टैंडिंग इन द मेडिटेशन एंड दे स्टार्टेड टू सिंग ए हिम. एक गाना गाया उन्होंने. अब इसको गुजराती में अलग लोग गुजराती में, गुजराती लोग गुजराती भाषा में गाते हैं, मारवाड़ी लोग मारवाड़ी भाषा में गाते हैं और हिंदी लोग हिंदी भाषा में गाते हैं. बट एट द टाइम द लैंग्वेज वॉज मे बी प्राकृत, सो उन्होंने तो शायद प्राकृत में गाया होगा. बट आई एम मारवाड़ी, सो आई नो मारवाड़ी व्हाट दे सेइंग. तो उन्होंने एक गीत गाया, वीरा मारा गज थकी हेटा उतरा. ओ माई डियर ब्रदर, now at least go down from the elephant. Ek baar nahi kaha, sang again and again throughout the day, they constantly sang it. Now Bahubali listen the voice of their voice of his sisters, he recognized that this song is sing by Brahmi and Sundari. So why they are saying the Veera Mara Gajataki Eta Utro? Oh my dear brother, come down from the elephant. Where is the elephant? I'm standing on the ground. I'm not sitting on the elephant. So why are they saying, where is the elephant? Again and again he contemplated on this, and there, on the other side, he also trusts, he has trust that these are nuns, they can't say wrong. They can't say la. So it means there is something mysterious. There is something secret behind that. And then he contemplated why they are saying that I have to get down from elephant. And after his contemplation, he got the clue, he got the answer, and he said, okay, my sisters are saying to get down from the elephant of ego. अहंकार के हाथी से मुझे नीचे उतरना है, अहम के गद से मुझे नीचे उतरना है, और मे बी दैट इज प्रिवेंटिंग मी टू गेट एनलाइटनमेंट. अदरवाइज एक साल हो गया, इतनी कड़ी साधना के बाद कोई केवल ज्ञान नहीं होता. और माई ईगो इज दैट हाउ कैन आई बॉल डाउन टू माई यंगर ब्रदर. बाहुबली ने रिग्रेट किया, ही रिग्रेटेड, जस्ट ही कॉन्टम्पलेटेड एंड रिग्रेटेड and became ready to give up his ego. He decided, okay, right now I will go to Bhagwan Rishabdev's assembly and I will bow down to my younger brothers, because now they are not younger than me, but they are senior than me. As soon as he decided, he stepped out, first step, and he got given down. Enlightenment. Brothers and sisters, this is the story. Many times we have heard, many times we have read. We know what is the moral of this story. Let me take your views. What is the moral of this story?
Don't tell the group.
Sabbath, can you write the views of people? Okay, one by one. First moral? फर्स्ट मॉरल क्या है स्टोरी का? कम ऑन, डोंट हैव ईगो. दिस शोज दैट ईगो इज ए बिग हर्डल इन अचीविंग एनलाइटनमेंट. अहंकार बहुत बड़ी बाधा है केवल ज्ञान प्राप्त करने के लिए. Today's subject is an integrated personality by bowing down. Okay? So, integrated personality. If we think in spiritual field, integrated personality means, perfect personality means to achieve Keval Gyan. Once if you have achieved Keval Gyan, you have achieved integrated personality in spiritual field. So, to get that integrated personality, ego is a big hurdle in achieving that. First thing. The second thing?
Don't be stubborn.
Any other moral we can find from this story?
Stubbornness. Don't be stubborn.
Don't be stubborn. That is same, that don't have ego and stubborn. Stubborn, arrogant, ego, these are the same. Any other?
Anger.
How? Can you explain?
Anger.
Huh?
What do you mean?
In a story, how can you explain that there was anger and that's why this is...
Well, because there was war between two brothers.
Very good. So, ego leads us to anger. And anger leads to breaking up relationship. You know? This may bhai bhai ka sambandh bhi toot sakta hai. As Bahubali did with Bharat. Yeah. So anger, ego leads to anger, and anger leads to bad relationship. Any other?
Respect to the learned ones.
Very good. Yeah. Regardless of their age, sadhus, sadhis, they should be respected. They should be saluted. Doesn't matter they are 9 years old or 90 years old, but they are adorable, they are respected. Any other?
Right. Right.
Right. Right. Right. Ego. Don't have ego and try the thing.
Greed.
Deception.
Greed. Greed is also greed. There. Yeah. Because of greed, they had that word. So greed is also an obstacle. Any other?
Bahubali ne kaha tha ki jameen Bharat ki hai, main khara hoon iske upar. To isliye.
That was ego. That was ego.
That's the part of ego.
That was ego. Yeah, I am standing on the Bharat.
Bharat
plan, yeah. So that was ego.
Deceit does not bring victory.
Sorry?
Deceit does not bring victory or success. Bharat tried
Bharat
to deceive.
Bharat ne try kiya tha, yeah? That
it
is
failed.
Also. Dekhi, ab kaise sare emotion, ek emotion, bad emotion aata hai, to sare aate, ek ego aya, to gussa bhi aya, lobh bhi aya, and abhi Harshad bhai keh rahe hai maya. Kyunki Bharat ne maya ki. Rule break kiya. Very good. आप ये नहीं कह सकते कि हम खाली ईगो छोड़ेंगे तो हम केवल ज्ञानी हो जाएंगे. ईगो छोड़ेंगे तो एंगर भी छूटेगा, माया भी छूटेगी, लोभ भी छूटेगा. वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट मॉरल
मेक्स यू फॉरगेट द विवेक.
हाउ कैन यू एक्सप्लेन इन द स्टोरी
यू फॉरगॉट टू रिस्पेक्ट हिज ब्रदर्स एंड रिस्पेक्ट
दैट इनडायरेक्टली कम इन
बिकॉज़ ऑफ
दैट इनडायरेक्टली कम इन ईगो एंड एंगर व्हाटएवर. Wonderful message from the story.
Moving on.
Very good. Salutation, humility, courtesy. As soon as Bahubali decided to salute his brother, he didn't salute. He didn't go there. He didn't reach there. Before reaching, as soon as he decided, and he got given. Humility is the main principle in Jainism. Ek vinamrata. एक कर्टसी, एक पोलाइटनेस आती है, ईगो भी चला जाता है, एंगर भी चला जाता है, माया भी चली जाती है, लोभ भी चला. और क्या आ जाता है? क्या आ जाता है? What we get? What Bahubali got? Integrated personality. Okay, so this is from story. So now today's subject is an integrated personality by bowing in reverence. So Ajna subject is an integrated personality by bowing in reverence. So in that subject I have to take so many subjects, many various subjects. First thing, what is personality, what is integrated personality, then what is ego, how ego becomes harder, then to whom we should salute, and then this, you know that this is a series of lectures. In the series of lectures, this is the third lecture, the third avashyam, Vandana avashyam. So today we have third lecture in six essential activities. We talked about Chavisattva, we talked about Pratyajan, and today we have third lecture on Vandana avashyam. So by bowing down, bowing in reverence, it means salutation, it means Vandana avashya. So I have to talk on Vandana also, I have to talk on Guru also, I have to talk on ego, I have to talk on personality, integrated personality. So first of all, I think we should have an activity, a discussion. So I need two groups. One group will discuss on what is personality and four questions there. What is personality? How many kinds of personality? What is an integrated personality and why should one develop a wholesome personality? One group will discuss on these points. The another group will discuss what is ego and how ego becomes harder in achieving integrated personality. Bolo, kon ready hoga? Char logon ka ek group bana lo. Who will discuss? Who is ready? हमारे पास यंग टीम है, यंग टीम विल टॉक ऑन ईगो, ओके? ये चारों बैठे हैं, केवल मालिनी, डीजल एंड तुम्हारा नाम क्या?
अनुजा,
ओके, योर ग्रुप विल टॉक ऑन ईगो, हाउ ईगो इज बेनिफिशियल, हाउ ईगो इज हार्मफुल, हाउ ईगो इज एंड ईगो कैन बिकम ए हर्डल इन अचीविंग इंटेग्रेटिव पर्सनैलिटी. नाउ फॉरगेट अबाउट इंटेग्रेटिव पर्सनैलिटी इन स्पिरिचुअल फील्ड. Forget about Keval Gyan. We are not going to get Keval Gyan right now. Okay? So we have to talk in day-to-day life. What is personality? The other group will talk about personality. And that is again not the in a spiritual field. In modern day, modern time, in at present, what is the definition of personality? And what is the definition of integrated personality for a worldly people? Forget about sadhus, forget about Keval Gyan, forget about moksha. Because first we have to lead our day-to-day life properly. Okay? So you all are worldly people, and worldly people, for worldly people, what is an integrated personality? And how these factors like ego is beneficial for them and harmful for them. Okay? So just you have to talk on ego, how it becomes harder or beneficial to develop your personality and integrated personality. But don't talk about moksha and sadhu and liberation and no. In your day-to-day life, in your at present personality, okay? The another group will talk about personality. What is personality? Again, I will say, forget about moksha and spirituality. If Keval Gyan nahi aaya to integrative personality nahi aayi. Abhi humko wo nahi. Aaj ki hamari paribhasha kya hai? At present, what definition of integrative personality and what, how many kinds of that and why should we develop? Kyunki aaj personality development ki bahut charcha chalti hai. So many workshops are going on, so many trainings are given, so many classes are running. एंड कितना पैसा लगा कर लोग इंटेग्रेटिव पर्सनालिटी को पाने के लिए कहाँ कहाँ चले जाते हैं. तो आज का अपना टॉपिक है लेट्स डिस्कस ऑन. कौन करेगा? राजीव भाई रेडी?
ओके,
ले लो दो चार को साथ में.
आई विल जॉइन राजीव.
ओके,
टू मोर. हां, यू विल जॉइन. आपका नाम है?
शैलेश
भाई. ओके, थ्री एंड वन मोर.
शैलेश.
Okay, so you talk. I give you 5 minutes.